Hey everyone, Madison Cawthorn here. Wanted to make a really quick video concisely responding to these criticisms of people believing that I support red flag laws. One, that is completely false. I believe the Second Amendment was written so that we can have a well-armed citizenry, because as soon as we give up our weapons, we are no longer citizens, but we're subjects. The Second Amendment was written so that if we ever needed to stop tyranny, we could do so. That is what it's for, clear and simple. I am trying to abolish the NFA, trying to work on this Hearings Protections Act, trying to make sure SBR is taking off the NFA first thing as fast as I possibly can, and then I want to abolish the NFA in totality later as soon as we gain the majority. But the reason I had to take a vote yesterday, which is one that is the National Defense Authorization Act, which is one that is used to actually pay for our military, give them a pay raise, all of these things. The reason I had to vote for it yesterday, and let me explain it, that when just because it passed in this first iteration does not mean that this is going into law. It has to go through this system, what's called taking it to conference, and it has to go through the Senate, and then we have to vote on it again. So this was not actually passing this into law. There's a lot of minutia behind the scenes of how Washington works with this. So I promise you, this red flag bullshit is not going into law. The reason we had to vote for this is because so many of our active duty military who are refusing to take the vaccine are being dishonorably discharged. And that basically makes them a felon in our society. And that is something that I think is just absolutely wrong and incorrect. Unfortunately, we had a stolen election, so therefore Joe Biden is in command of our military and he's trying to force all of these vaccines down the throats of our military. And so the reason we had to vote for this and get it through quickly is so that it would prohibit people who decline to take the vaccine in the military from being dishonorably discharged. Now, let me explain to you the red flag portion of that. So that was a portion that, yes, it is in that bill, but then it went going into conference. I've spoken to people on the Senate side, and I know for a fact this will not go into law. This part will be stripped out of it. If it is not in it, I will absolutely burn it to the ground. That is impossible, and I'll make sure it does not pass through the House. So I just want to let you all know I am not betrayed anybody in the Second Amendment community. I promise I will always have your back. I am armed every single day. I believe that we should be armed just as equipped as the military. That's exactly what our founding fathers intended for us. And so I promise I have your back. I promise I am not betraying you, and I give you my word. In the coming weeks, you will see that the red flag portion is going to be stripped out of it. I am working tirelessly behind the scenes to make sure that happens. So I promise you all, I'm with you. Had to get this passed, one, so that we can make sure that our brave servicemen and women who refuse the vaccine because it shouldn't be mandated are not dishonorably discharged. But this red flag portion of it is not going to be in there, because red flag laws are unconstitutional, they're wrong, and they're just being weaponized. I promise you that. So please bear with me for the next few weeks. I promise you, I give you my word. If I'm lying to you, do not reelect me. I give you my word, red flag laws will not be going into law. Please, that's all I wanted to let you all know. Thanks.